The one thing I think you have to be so careful about the first 4 days of the big dance is how you look at Cinderella. And every year you're going to have a Cinderella. Every year. But from a gambling perspective, this is what you have to consider. How does that slipper fit the second time around? Because every Thursday and Friday, you're going to have a Cinderella story emerge, right? But how does that slipper fit on a Saturday or a Sunday? Well, in the case of Loyola Chicago, it's fit pretty damn good. I mean, you talk about dramatic wins. Well, the Ramblers certainly qualify after knocking off Miami of Florida and Tennessee. But then the other end of the spectrum, you have Buffalo. How the Bulls inspired so much confidence in bettors after taking care of Arizona? A lot of people lost a lot of money on Buffalo yesterday because they really thought that they would stay within the number against Kentucky. Anthony Redd certainly did. He had his first ever 200 dime play yesterday. And listen, I'm not beating up Anthony Redd, but the fact is a lot of gamblers went down that rabbit hole with Buffalo yesterday and they got beat into a pulp. And today we have the biggest Cinderella of all time, Maryland-Baltimore County. Let me ask you something. If Maryland-Baltimore County was playing Kansas State, and this game was in November, December, January, or February, and if this game was played long before we knew what Maryland-Baltimore County did to Virginia the other night, would this game be a 10.5-point spread? Wouldn't Kansas State be laying 17, 18 points instead? Yeah, this is a Maryland-Baltimore County team that lost by 44 points to Albany earlier this year. Exactly. So where's the line value in this game? Oh, because they were a Cinderella team and the slipper fit the other night. Just saying. Don't know. Don't like the game at all. Wouldn't touch it myself. You have another Cinderella team in a way. Nevada today. This is a Nevada team that couldn't beat San Diego State earlier this year. San Diego State kind of is a similar team to Cincinnati. A bigger physical team. But Nevada's going to stay within Cincinnati, that point spread today? Possibly could. I'm not saying, I mean, listen, I think if Nevada shoots the hell out of the ball, you know, has a great game from three-point land, they could easily cover. Shoulda, coulda, woulda, I'm just saying. But, you know, that's the thing you always have to be so careful with when it comes to the Cinderella stories. Marshall could be another Cinderella story, and I'm going to break down that game against West Virginia for you today in just a moment among your complimentary plays. But again, it's just a very interesting thing in the first 4 days. You always had the Cinderella story on Thursday and Friday. Does the slipper fit again on Saturday and Sunday? And you always have the overreaction because Vegas knows that you, as the gambler, you're looking at Cinderella and you're going, man, I'm in love with Buffalo. I think they can beat Kentucky. Really? Maryland-Baltimore County? Yeah. They should really be getting 17 points today against Kansas State. 10.5 points? Again, I'm not a big fan of Kansas State, but Kansas State, Maryland-Baltimore County? Eh, just saying. Hey, Jack Raymond won again last night. Jack Raymond's winning a hell of a lot just about most of these nights. Jack Raymond last night, another, what was his 100 dime winner? Oh, same play I had last night. It was Gonzaga. So today, Jack Raymond, who's going for winning day number 11 out of 14. The past 13 days, he's made $10 bettors, a little over $9,100. Once again, upping the ante today, 11th ever 200 dime double your wager college basketball release since he's joined this site. Second round game of the year, Auburn and Clemson. Hit the 10th ever 200 dime release on a Friday night with Charleston getting the cover against Auburn. Won the 9th ever 200 dime play with Arizona over Southern Cal last Saturday in the Pac-12 championship game. God, that seems like forever ago. And of course, he's on a 28-14 run with those 100 dime plays after scoring with Gonzaga last night. You've got in all these plays for over half price off. Same thing goes today, over half price off from Jack Raymond, simply by using coupon code Jack, J-A-C-K, his first name. As for me, I am, I'm going for the 7th profitable weekend in the past 8 weekends. I've turned a profit 6 of the last 7. Last night I hit with Gonzaga. That is my normal top-rated 15-dime play. Today, for only the 28th time in the 15 years since I created these sites, I have a raise-the-bar 20-dime play. It is on the early game between Purdue and Butler. It is the half-price play of the day by using coupon code RAISE, R-A-I-S-E. R-A-I-S-E. I had to think for a second. What is it? 7:30 this morning. I started working at 10:30 last night, and I'm shooting a video. I'm tired of this week. I can't wait for today to be over. As soon as this video is over, my day is over. So let's get this video over and let's move forward. All your other discounts and coupon codes are over on the homepage. Let's get to the complimentary plays. What do you say? I think that's a good idea so I can get this over with and move forward. Let's get to the complimentary plays. Let's talk about the Marshall game against West Virginia. I think it's a fascinating game. This game, of course, is in San Diego. Marshall pulling the upset of Wichita State, 81-75. John Elmore continues his red-hot role here in the postseason. He averaged 22.9 points here in the season. Had 27 against Wichita. You know, this is going to be a great matchup in the backcourt, although they may not play each other. Javon Carter, the two-time defending Defensive Player of the Year in the Big 12. We'll see a lot of action on Elmore for West Virginia. You've got a team that's going to shoot a lot of three-pointers who, you know, listen, that's Marshall's MO. The best shot is a three-point shot against a team that's going to press the hell out of them and try to create turnovers in West Virginia. You know, you have a program in Marshall that used to play West Virginia every single year. They have not played each other since 2016 because if West Virginia can't play the game in Morgantown, they don't want to play it in Charleston in a neutral site. They don't want to play in Huntington. So there you go. So chip on the shoulder for Marshall. I just think that in this game, I would much rather take the 12.5 points with Marshall and give them a shooter's chance to cover the spread. So I like Marshall in this contest. Another game for you is going to be the game between North Carolina and Texas A&M. This Texas A&M squad, big, absolutely. You know, they have a huge advantage in terms of the big guys up front with Robert Williams and, Tyler Davis. You know, Luke May is the biggest guy at 6'8" for North Carolina, who went to a primarily smaller lineup as the season progressed. North Carolina statistically has a rebound margin which is the fourth best in the country. They have a plus 10.2 rebound margin compared to Texas A&M's at plus 6.3. Forget about that figure. It really is inconsequential because North Carolina, when it counts, usually gets outboarded. However, North Carolina is a much better offensive team. And at 6.5 points, I have watched Texas A&M repeatedly this year get beaten by inferior clubs. You look at this Texas A&M team, their problem is they're a great team from about 12 feet out. They're a team that gets the bulk of their points inside. They're a horrendous three-point shooting team. They're a team that has to funnel the ball inside, which with their height and with their size, you can understand why. They get 56% of their scoring on two-pointers, which is 24th best in the nation, and they better, because they only shoot about 33% from three-point range. This is a North Carolina team that has so many different facets offensively. They can beat you so many ways offensively. And again, I've watched Texas A&M just play so poorly against so many teams this year. And really, if you look at the Aggies, they played their best games at home, not on the road. So I'm willing to go with North Carolina playing in their backyard in Charlotte, where they're 12-0 lifetime in tournament games, 5-0 at the Spectrum Center, 34-1 lifetime playing in the state of North Carolina. I'm willing to lay the 6.5 points here with Roy Williams as they advance to the Sweet 16, because I just think they're a more dynamic team. I think Texas A&M is going to try to take the air out of the ball. They're going to try to play at a slower pace. North Carolina is going to try to accelerate the action, play a little more up-tempo, but again, I do like North Carolina in this game. I want to talk about an NIT game here. It's going to be the game between Baylor and Mississippi State. You know, I use Baylor as a top-rated 15-dime play in their NIT opener against Wagner on Tuesday night, and they crushed Wagner, which they should have. Wagner was an eighth seed. Baylor a number one seed. They're playing the game in Waco. Baylor 14-3 straight up at home this season. Today they're taking on a Mississippi State team that may be without one of their starting guards, Nick Witherspoon, who missed Mississippi State's opening night win in the NIT on Wednesday night against Nebraska. Now, they took care of business against Nebraska, but remember, Nebraska is a team that really found success in the second half of the season when they went to a smaller lineup. They're going to be playing a very big physical Baylor team today, Mississippi State. A Mississippi State team that when you took them out of Starkville this season, they went 2-8 straight up. Baylor, 14-3, playing at home this season. Big physical team. I think Baylor has so many advantages here. I like Baylor minus the 6 points in this game. Another interesting NIT game, Middle Tennessee State. After blowing their chance at the big dance by losing their regular season finale to Marshall and then getting ousted in the quarterfinals of Conference USA, where they were the defending champions in the tournament by Southern Miss, they get relegated to the NIT. And before their first game against Vermont, Kermit Davis, their head coach for the past 16 years, takes the job at Ole Miss. But he is staying on throughout the NIT tournament. They go out and beat the hell out of Vermont at home. What was the final score? I just want to look at 91-64. So now they're going to Louisville. Louisville came back from a 3-point halftime deficit to beat Northern Kentucky by 8 points in a game that Louisville, you had to question their motivation, because prior to the ACC tournament, the Louisville players more or less decided that they didn't want to play in any other tournament other than the dance, if they didn't make the dance. Well, they didn't. But the word was, according to various reports, that since the school had accepted an invitation to the NIT, after Louisville did not get a big dance invite, the athletic director reportedly told the Cardinal players that, hey, if you don't, no problem, we just have to forfeit. So the players then decided, reportedly, that they would then take the NIT invite. And they took on Northern Kentucky. They rallied in the second half, shot the hell out of the ball, won the game, managed to cover by a half point. This is a Louisville team that played poorly down the stretch, closed the regular season on a 3-7 tailspin, lost to Virginia in their second tournament game. Middle Tennessee State was 12-1 on the road this season, true road games. I think they can stay within the number of 5 points at Louisville this season. I think that they will, I think they already got the, how do I say it, the grief, the sense of loss from being shunned and blowing their chance in a 5-day stretch of making the big dance. And I like the way they played against Vermont the other night. Now, Vermont and Louisville, two totally different teams. But I think with Davis leaving their head coach, with them having a second chance here, I like them against a team in Louisville that may not be motivated for this game either. So I like Middle Tennessee State. If I had to rank these plays, I would take Marshall number one with Baylor, North Carolina on line number two, and Middle Tennessee State on line number three. So those are your plays for today. Wish you well. Talk to you again tomorrow when we do it again.